write down the arrangement of atoms. Packing also we call it as packing of atoms or arrangement of atoms. Okay, so what kind of arrangement will prefer? The arrangement which gives the maximum efficiency, packing efficiency, that is preferable, right? So mainly two types of arrangement we have. The first one write down square close packing. Two types of arrangement we have. The first one is square close packing. In square close packing, the atoms are arranged like this. All atoms are in contact, one above the other. Like this, the atoms are arranged. Okay, one above the other. This vacant space is what? Okay. The other arrangement is not important that much. The other arrangement is hexagonal close packing. Hexagonal close packing. In hexagonal close packing, we'll arrange the atom this way. This is the most difficult part of this chapter, because this diagram is important and it's very difficult to draw. Okay. Now in the second layer, we'll place the atoms in the space between the two atoms. Okay, so first atom will place here, which one is the better packing, this one or this one? This one, right? Because it occupies more space. Okay, just want to see which is required, like what I have to, you know, make you understand that should be visible. So the diagram should be like this. This diagram is given in NCERT. Okay, you can go and check. Okay, this is the first layer where we place the atoms in between the space of the two atoms in the first layer. Okay. Now, here what happens, this is suppose layer A, okay, and if you want to put in another layer of these atoms, so we can place the atoms at the, you know, void of this, okay, we'll place the atom here. Here also, if you try to put, you get an atom here, like this. Okay. Now you see this space here. I'm not drawing the entire thing because nothing you'll understand. Okay, it's completely messed up. see this one. This space is vacant here, this one, which forms by one, this orange one, two, and this three. Three sphere in the first layer, and four, which is this yellow one, fifth yellow one, and sixth this yellow one. So you'll have a space here, vacant space here. Hit this blue one, this one. Can you see this? This one, if you see, it is something like this. This three sphere in the first layer A, and this three sphere in the there's two triangle like this, as I have first layer mein, and then as I have second layer. You'll have a space in there. This diagram is given in the book. When you go to home, just NCRT India watches it. You can go and check. Okay? You'll understand this. So, one more thing I'll just tell you here. These two spheres are in contact. You don't touch me. Right? Two void you consider. Can you see this void? That is void one. And this is the another void, which is above this sphere, and 1, 2, 3. This is the second type of void. What is the difference in these two void? This void forms by the combination of six sphere. 1, 2, 3 in the first layer. 1, 2, 3 in the second layer. Okay? This void forms by the combination of six. So can you see that six sphere, right? So this is void one, and it is an octahedral void because it forms by combination of six layer. This void forms by 1, 2, 3 and one layer in the bottom. This one, four sphere. So this is tetrahedral void. So tetrahedral void is some. This is octahedral void. Tetrahedral void is something like this. You have a three sphere, and when you place another sphere on this. So, beech mein jo space bachega vacant, that is a tetrahedral void. Theek hai? So, now you see one thing here. The layer is A and the second layer is B. Theek hai? You have two options here. When you try to put the third layer on this, you have two options here. You can fill this void or this void. Correct? Now, if you want to fill this void, you'll get another layer C. Different one, another layer C. But if you want to fill this void, the void of sphere comes exactly above the this sphere. Is it possible? Can you see this? If you want to fill this void, you put in a sphere like this. So this sphere comes exactly above the sphere of the first layer. So many. You have this sphere now. The sphere of layer A. This sphere. You want to fill this void? So you put in a sphere like this. Okay? This comes exactly above the layer A. Sphere of the layer A. Similarly, यहाँ पे भी एक tetrahedral void होगा. If you want to fill this इसके ऊपर, तो layer A के opposite है. ठीक है? So when you try to fill this void too, which is a tetrahedral void, you get which layer? Layer A again. Then again you'll get layer B, A, B, A, B. Right? So if you want to fill this void, you'll get A layer again. So that arrangement is A B A B A B kind of arrangement. Okay? But if you want to fill this void, octahedral void, you'll get a layer C. Right, layer C. So that is ABC, ABC kind of arrangement. Got it? Okay. One more thing I'll tell you. You just look at this structure. This to center. What is this? Hexagon. Right? Hexagon में देखो, all corner atoms are in touch, ठीक है? एक face center में. You look at the structure of that hexagon वाला, HCP वाला structure you see. वहाँ पे मैंने क्या कहा? कि corner atoms are in touch, ठीक है? एक face center पे है. और ये जो तीन sphere तुम्हें दिख रहा है देखो, layer B में, the yellow one, 1, 2, and 3. It is in between this. Because you'll have, when you put the layer AB, AB, AB like that, you'll get a hexagon pattern in which this three atoms is present in between that. That is HCP arrangement. हेक्सागन दिख रहा है ना, हेक्सागन दिख रहा है, और यू हैव दिस थ्री स्क्वायर 1, 2 and 3, और हेक्सागन में क्या था, एटम्स एट द कॉर्नर इन टच और एक फेस सेंटर पे, राइट? सो दिस 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 एट द कॉर्नर, और ये फेस सेंटर वाला ये जो है दिस इज इन टच विद ऑल सिक्स, दैट इज व्हाट हेक्सागन आई हैव गिवन यू. सो व्हेन यू put the another layer, you'll get a hexagon pattern like this. Okay, or uska kuch height hoga, that height is edge that we have done the reservation. Okay, so these three atoms is in between the two AB layer. You got it? This is layer A, the first one. Layer B, the three atoms in between is the atoms of layer B. Then again we have layer A, then again we have layer B, three atoms, then again we have layer A. That is HCP array. Sorry, okay, so in this one thing you write down, case 1, if you place the layer, place the sphere in such a way that it covers void 2, which is tetrahedral void. Place the sphere in such a way that it covers void 2. We observe that each sphere of the third layer lies exactly above. The sphere of the first layer. If we continue with this arrangement, we'll get AB tight packing. Caps you write down like this. AB type packing. AB type packing. Okay? And this is nothing but HCP, hexagonal close packing. Reason I have just discussed now. Okay? We are getting a hexagon here, right? Then three sphere of layer B. Again you'll get layer A hexagon, then again layer B, again layer A. Okay, so this is HCP that we have discussed. Okay? This arrangement is known as HCP arrangement, hexagonal close packing. Okay. Now you see here, coordination number we were discussing, correct? So this sphere, you see, this sphere is surrounded by how many atoms? Six of this in the same layer, three in the above layer, ठीक है? और three नीचे भी तो होगा.
Twelve.
ये A के नीचे B है. और ऊपर भी है, right? So this 3 of B, 6 of A, and then again 3 of B. That's why the coordination number is 12. मैंने बोला था ना arrangement में, we'll discuss this, right? So वहाँ पे it's difficult to understand. Okay? You understand why it is ABAB, and hence it is HCP, and how coordination number is 6. 6 in the same layer, 3 above it, and 3 below it, right? That's why the coordination number is 12. Okay? Next, write down. Case 2, if you place the atom to fill the void 1, we get ABC type arrangement. And this is known as FCC or CCP arrangement. FCC or CCP, both are same thing. Cubic close packing, face center cubic arrangement. Okay, it is known as FCC or CCP arrangement. Okay, in this also the coordination number is 12. FCC though we have discussed how the coordination number is 12. Okay, coordination number is 12. Write down, next line. Case 3, there is a third type of arrangement of packing. this third type of arrangement of spheres. And in this, the sphere in the first layer is not in contact. Last one, first layer is not in contact. So mainly we have two types, square close packing, hexagonal close packing. HCP is the better packing, better method we have, where we get what? More packing efficiency. The third type we have, like this, when the atoms are not in contact in the first layer.
So we got same packing efficiency for hexagon or hexagon?
HCP and FCC has same packing efficiency.
Then how is FCC better?
Both you can have. Like HCP, if you talk about the packing efficiency, HCP and FCC is equally good because both gives equal packing efficiency. Okay. Generally, we won't get HCP. We have in the syllabus we have QV close packing. So mainly we deal with FCC, but which one is better? We can compare FCC and BCC. We can compare FCC and simple cubic unit cell, BCC and simple cubic unit cell. But overall, HCP and FCC has equally good in terms of packing because their packing efficiency is same. Okay. So this is the next arrangement we have, where atoms are not in touch, like this. And when you place the another layer, to fill a void like this, which is also not in touch. This arrangement is BCC arrangement. BCC arrangement, we know K does not equals to 2R, right? So this arrangement is BCC arrangement, which has the not much good packing efficiency. Obviously, the atoms are not in touch, so their packing efficiency is not very good, right? So this is the third type of arrangement here. The best one is HCP, okay? And in this, we are getting only FCC and HCP arrangement. So today we understood the various unit cell, various type of packing, and packing efficiency. Okay, the location of void is very important. Okay, where we get octahedral void, where we get tetrahedral void. Okay, all these things are very important. Today, when you go home, this structure is given in NCERT in koi book mein diya hua hai. Okay, just give a reading to it. Okay, arrangement of atoms, packing of arrangements pe ek baar dekh lo, wahan pe structure se banaya hua hai, void you can, yes, this one only. Here you see it is given, tetrahedral, octahedral, you can see easily the voids, how it is octahedral, how it is tetrahedral. So all these, this structure we have discussed just now. So page number 13 is given. Page number 12 to page number 12 to 13. These 2-3 pages you must read. Okay, we'll discuss next class questions on it. Okay, void location, minimum distance, and all that is very important. Okay, must you know that. So okay, bye.
Thank you, sir.